Hello, Calvary, and welcome to your word for the day. My name is Mitch, and I am the children's pastor here at Calvary, and we are continuing our favorite Bible characters series today, and I chose Moses. I love reading about the people in the Old Testament. Their stories may seem mythical and full of adventure, or sometimes even pointless and boring at first. But when you dig into these stories, when you realize that these are real stories about real people, and you begin to think about their story within the context of the overarching story of the Bible, you realize that these people's stories were not included for no reason, but because God wants to use their experiences to communicate something to us. Moses is one of my favorite people written about in the Bible, not because he's a perfect role model, because he's not, nor because God used him to do amazing things, but because he was so imperfect, and yet God still chose to use him. See, his story starts off as an Israelite infant that was meant to be murdered by the Pharaoh of Egypt, but he instead grew up in the Pharaoh's household as a prince of Egypt. But Moses' life didn't turn out as all rainbows and sunshine. One day he saw an Egyptian beating an Israelite slave, and so in a fit of rage, he killed the Egyptian, and he ran away to save his own life. He then spent a few decades living as a shepherd in the desert and building a family when he was called by God. From a burning bush that wouldn't actually burn up, God spoke to him and called him to be a leader. And I absolutely love this part because it shows us Moses as a real person. Moses saw the task that God was calling him to, and he knew that he wasn't qualified. He had many insecurities, and those insecurities kept telling him that he wasn't good enough. He wasn't a good leader. No one would listen to him. His past was full of mistakes. He wasn't even a gifted public speaker. But God knew that he could still use Moses to do great and mighty things. And through the rest of his life, God used Moses to perform some amazing miracles. Reading through the rest of Moses' story takes us through the 10 plagues against Egypt, God leading his people with pillars of fire and smoke, the splitting of the Red Sea, food falling from heaven, water pouring from rocks, and people being healed. But even as Moses followed God, we see that his life still was not perfect. He still struggled with controlling his anger. He had problems balancing work and family life. He struggled with being a control freak. He wrestled with his doubts that God would actually come through. And through all of this, God saw his obedience despite his imperfections. And he said, write that down. That is good stuff. Put that in the Bible. And maybe this is why I like Moses so much. I have many of the same insecurities and faults that Moses had. Often the thoughts go through my head that there are other people who could be more effective at ministry than I am. That someone else could have preached the message better, that I shouldn't get so worked up over minor issues, that I should be better at handling my own work-life balance. And maybe you're struggling with your own insecurities as well. Your past is too messed up. You feel like a failure at home. You've destroyed too many relationships. Maybe you're letting those insecurities keep you from following the plan that God has for you. Take a moment and listen to what God is saying to you. What is God calling you to do? How is God calling you to be obedient? I believe that we are each in a unique situation where we are the best people uniquely positioned to help fulfill God's plan here on earth. There are certain people that you have the best platform to speak love and hope into their life. There are certain ways that your unique gifts and abilities can contribute to the mission to lead people to Jesus in a way that no one else can. If you are a believer and you're still breathing, it's because God wants to use you to do some amazing things. Moses was all sorts of messed up, and God still used him to do great things. Don't let your past stop you from following God's call on your life. Don't let your weaknesses keep you from chasing after God's plan. 2 Corinthians 2:9 from the NIV, God is speaking to the author Paul here, and he says, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness." Guys, God's grace is sufficient for you. God's power is made perfect in your weakness. Let me challenge you today to choose to follow God despite your weaknesses. No matter your imperfections or insecurities, God has a plan for you to do great and mighty things. The one choice you have to make is whether you will choose to listen to God or your own insecurities. Have a great day. We'll see you next time.